Well, back home, Kevin Rudd faced rowdy protesters today but emerged smiling after securing his party's backing for his controversial PNG solution. The first group of asylum seekers to be told that's their destination, not Australia, were left clearly distressed. Adam Todd reports.
Kevin Rudd isn't used to getting this kind of reception when he walks down the street. In Balmain, birthplace of the Labor Party in New South Wales, he faced comparisons to a conservative foe.
We don't need another Howard.
His first caucus meeting since returning to the top job, a flashpoint for anger over his so-called PNG solution for asylum seekers. This man burning his Labor membership card.
And any left-wing member of the ALP should walk up.
But it's votes from the right Kevin Rudd is chasing, and he wouldn't have been too disappointed to hear the Coalition and the Greens speaking with one voice.
This particular deal is unravelling before our very eyes.
His PNG proposition has increasingly unravelled.
It's an election fix.
It is an election fix.
The PM unapologetic for taking a hard line on people smugglers.
These folk are merchants in death.
Vision today of asylum seekers on Christmas Island, the first to be told they'll be heading to PNG, not Australia.
Over the coming days, because they've only just arrived, they'll start to contemplate very seriously whether, in fact, returning home is a better option.
Caucus backing Kevin Rudd's policy shift, support too for his internal reforms, making it harder to knife a Labor leader. 75% of caucus now needed to oust a Labor PM, party members given an equal say in a leadership ballot.
I trust the rank and file a lot more than I trust some of my colleagues.
I am perfectly relaxed in surrendering our future to you.
As for when Kevin Rudd will surrender his future to voters at the ballot box, the guessing game continues. Speculation we could go to the polls on August 31.
In this period of government, we've been focused on the outstanding policy challenges that we face, and there are still a number to address.
He's not ready to name a date just yet.
And we have some numbers there coming through on News Poll, according to Ghost Who Votes tweeting tonight. The Coalition has regained its lead over the Labor Party just by a small amount in two-party preferred. The numbers, the ALP on 48 points, down 2 on the last News Poll. The Liberals and National Party up 2 points to 52. So 52-48 on a two-party preferred basis on those early numbers on News Poll tomorrow.